point at which I became acutely aware, if you could elicit one point, was driving through Everett. Everett is a lovely little town, and I drove through Everett, and it was boarded up and overgrown, and it stunned me. I was amazed. And I realized that something atrocious was happening.
The Cuyahoga Valley follows the Cuyahoga River for approximately 24 miles between Akron and Cleveland, Ohio. And the remarkable thing about the valley is that it has remained so unspoiled.
Well, I think the reason that population stayed the same is because no housing developments or no new people came there much, because there wasn't any land available. Most of the people kept their land all the time, and the births and deaths just about balanced out each other, I think. And practically everybody in the whole township is related, you know. If you start talking about somebody in Vanessa, you're talking about your cousin or second cousin or...
On December 27, 1974, Congress designated 32,000 acres of the Cuyahoga Valley as a national recreation area. Of the 32,000 acres, 16,000 acres were existing state parks. Only 2.5% of the land was used for residential purposes, and according to the act passed by Congress, almost all that property would be given a scenic easement, which would permit the residents to still own their land, but would stop any development. An Interior Department study reported that only 29 families would be relocated to make the park. But from the beginning, things didn't go as planned.
On the inception of the park, the stress was basically that this would not be a community removal program, but what was originally proposed and what has actually happened are really two different things. And of course, as you read the act passed by Congress, what they said and what the National Park Service has been doing are almost, if there's any similarity, it's almost accidental, it would seem. I think the effect has been disastrous.
Residents who balked at selling out to the park were put in condemnation in federal court, and their land was taken by the right of eminent domain. A federal judge determined the price they would be paid for their property. The threat of going to court, coupled with the land acquisition tactics of the National Park Service, prompted many of the old families to give up and move out of the valley.
We got a letter from in the mail from the park. They told us that the most that they could allow us would be 3 acres, which would include just where the barn and the house sit in the garden spot. But they said, we'll rent you ground if you want to stay and farm. I said, yeah, but I said, I don't want to rent ground from you people, because I had seen property that the park had purchased before. Tear the buildings down or burn them or whatever, and the place, the farms just grew up to nothing but weeds and brush. And I knew that's what would happen. And if we didn't sell out to them, our next door neighbors did, then we'd be right there with all that rubbish again. I said, now, what we've got here, I got a house and a barn, a tool shed, and a chicken house. Now, I said, what I want is equal. And he says, no. He said, we don't have to do that. According to law, all we're required to do is furnish you with a dwelling equivalent to what you had. I said, well, how do you expect me to carry on? Well, he said, you're not a big-time farmer, so he says it's classified as a hobby. I always had livestock, always raised food for them. Ever since I was a little kid, in fact, I've been farming. Well, what can you do?
Businesses located in the valley had to leave immediately. Burl Tonkin's one-man garage, a valley landmark for 35 years, was one of the first to go.
You know, they first came in and said they was Not going to move nobody out. You could, the district's going to buy easements in the state. You could stay the rest of your life if you wanted to. Then they kept changing it and changing the boundaries until the, what's happened now is where it's at. I got a letter of condemnation. Well, I'd heard, you know, rumors that that garage has got to go, you know. I felt pretty angry. But like the lawyer says, if you fight them, they'd take it in court and said if I wouldn't submit to death, they'd send our men in to take it. And he says, either you wind up dead or in a nut house or penitentiary. If it hadn't been for Grandma, I had to take care of her. Why, I probably would have let him try it that way. But well, I still got to look after her, so I just accept the inevitable. Or I'll either have to tree farm or do something there. I don't know what I could do. I'm not really a farmer. I probably could go out and work someplace, you know, and come back in the evenings.
In 1968, Carol Erdos posed for a snapshot in front of the four-room cabin that was situated on the 12 acres of land she and her husband Bill had just purchased. Over the next 10 years, working in the evenings, on weekends, and during vacations, the Erdos family built a spectacular home around the cabin. In 1977, their home was named as one of the 20 outstanding homes in the country by Architectural Record magazine.
We received a certified letter saying that they wanted to acquire our property in fee. You know, I'm familiar with the way the law is written, and I specifically ask why. Why has our property been selected for fee acquisition? I might be interested in selling an easement, a scenic easement, but, you know, I'd like to keep my property. And he said, well, that's, you know, the standard answer that I got was, it's been determined that yours is fee acquisition and there's no choice in the matter. And I said, well, I'd like to make a formal request that it be changed. And he said, it won't do you any good. Don't waste your time.
Like hundreds of other park residents who are being taken in condemnation, the Erdos family must think about moving out of the valley and the home they built for themselves.
What could happen to this property? I think they put it up for sealed bid, and you can buy it for the highest bid and either move it or disassemble it or tear it down for salvage value. And if they don't get an offer on it, as far as I know, they just contract somebody to come in and take it down.
Bob and Natalie Volkanoff came to the valley in 1947 and started a florist business. For the past 3.5 years, they've been hanging in limbo while the park moves to acquire their property.
This is the way they have appraised our properties. And we were told that it's a residence with an accessory building. And for an accessory building, I've maintained a business here for over 27 years. This has been going on for approximately 3.5 years because of the condemnation. We have gone with the Department of Justice. Now we start all over again.
Emotionally, I'm not too good anymore. First, I cried buckets of tears, and then I became very, very bitter. And then I have no emotions. And not knowing where you're going for 3 years, I don't think they should torture a human being like that. I really don't. If it was just our home, maybe we could adjust, but it's everything. It's our livelihood thing.
Well, it just makes you really feel upset. And I can see why people lose their health over it. Because no one knows when you live in a place like that for so many generations what that ground means to you. To just have somebody come along and say, I want it. And you're going to get out if we have to take it. And there's just never a place like where you grew up all your life.
I was up there during the summer, the old Scobie property. The windows were knocked out of the barn, and the grass and weeds was waist high or head high. In the garden, the weeds was great big high stuff, and it just looked just downright terrible, that's all. And they were supposed to keep it looking nice. We moved away from there just about a year ago, and it looks like nobody lived there for 10 years.
To me, it's dead. Oh, it was just something to go down through there and see all the people. But now, it's just completely absolutely dead. That's all there is to it in my mind. It changed all the buildings, tore down the old landmarks, and nothing is the same, that's all.